Hey.
Hey.
Hey guys.
Hey. Flags. We're playing Stratego. And we gotta find the flags. And I have no idea if it's called Stratego.
I believe,
in English,
yeah,
or in America.
Stratego.
It's not a soft G, okay. So it's not Stratego. That just sounds silly.
Stratego, yeah.
And scouts, spies, can find bombs or just. I'm not gonna lie. I don't play a lot of Stratego.
I was doubting because, Clue. What you call Clue is called Cluedo, for us. And I was like, well, that seems to be a thing to rename.
I thought it was Cluedo. When I saw European versions of it.
It's Blue's Clues Mystery Edition.
Oh!
Murder. Mystery.
Find out what killed this asshole with a pipe wrench. Hey, so, what are you playing? Dark Souls? What is this? What are we doing?
This is a newly hyped-released game, Dark Souls 2. They changed it a little bit. For one thing, you can't die anymore.
Oh, okay.
But everything else is exactly the same.
Yeah, this checks
sounds
out.
Like an improvement to me.
Way more approachable.
I remember last time we were playing Dust an Elysian Tale.
Dust Unleashed.
You were doing mansion stuff?
Yes. Then we're gonna do a couple of more mansion stuffs and
I
finish this chapter.
I caught my son doing a mansion, so I made him smoke the whole pack.
Did he say I learned it from watching you, Datterface?
No, but he should have. My son is not only stupid, but also an idiot.
Aww.
My son is also fake. I made him up.
I love my dead fake son.
Oh, that makes two of us. I'll miss him a lot.
Hey, a wizard.
It's a wizard. It can only be damaged by magic. It's just stupid because...
Oh my god, they're doing so many spells.
Wizards are supposed to be frail.
Yeah, the typical, like, solution to a wizard is get close to wizard,
blow at him, and it'll tip
hit,
over.
Hit wizard with physical punch sword.
Well, that wizard probably cast, like, magic armor on itself.
Oh, which only makes it a little harder to hit the wizard traditionally.
Look, it's a level, like, 20 epic wizard, so...
Then we're fucked. Like, he should be... Well, he's probably also stupid since he's not just... opening a rift to the abyss under our feet.
Well, not all level 20s are smart.
Yeah.
Some of them just...
He's got a lot of intelligence, but very little wisdom. Really.
Wizards seem like pains in the ass.
Yep. It's a good thing most of them die early.
Wizards are dicks. We don't have to fight all the wizards. As long as we keep them at bay, they won't stop us from progressing.
Oh man, I need to see a propaganda poster now that says keep the wizard at bay.
It's a,
muscle.
Two color, black and red for the portrait of a wizard.
Yeah. And then next to it is buy war bonds.
The barbarian is your friend!
Keep the wizard at bay!
If you look in the background, you can see mansions underground here. And I guess they collapsed, and now they're flooded. So, no, how do we get in?
Swim in there.
So it's like
can't
this
swim.
Just
there's
an
no
area
swimming in dust.
Where people grew mansions.
What, like a mansion farm?
Yeah. And like the mansions that rotted or whatever got buried for fertilizer for other mansions.
Ah, that's... Well, it might be. We're in the Nanoth Mansion now. That's cool. I've read it. What?
Hey,
ah!
Ghost Bro.
This guy! Again! He's
it's
back!
The same
this
guy.
This guy's green. I don't remember if the other one was or not.
He was green, yeah.
He was? Okay. I was wondering if this one had the additional status effect of poison.
Nice, he's green because...
He's envious.
He's jelly.
He's jealous of the living. Jealous of the flesh havers.
Well, he might actually he be jelly, but like mint-flavored jelly.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Is he gonna... Is he gonna sing about little pigs? Or...
That's green jello.
No, it's jelly. I checked. I got it on my old Bands of the 90s iPhone app right here.
You don't have an iPhone.
Shut it.
I just really need to be right about the band Green Jello, okay?
Well, okay.
Did you know in the track, the Three Little Pigs or whatever by Green Jello, or Jelly, if you're Chimp, the voice of the pigs was by Maynard James Keenan from Tool.
Hmm, I didn't know that. Clearly, I don't
check
know.
Check that on your iPhone app.
All right, let me, beep, boop, boop, beep, boop, boop, beep.
Aw, oh, Chimp, you ruined it. It's beep, 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 boop, boop, beep, beep. Now you've ruined it. It's not believable
no,
anymore.
No, it really sounded like an iPhone to me. I believe that Chimp has an iPhone now that he made those noises. So what did your app say, Chimp? Am I right or not?
It said Ladface is smart and pretty.
Oh,
forever.
Yeah, Chimp definitely has an iPhone. So we're looking at this mansion.
Yeah.
Breaking. Just got the second witchcraft item we needed. A diary, because...
Was there an infomercial that told us to collect all four?
There was a crazy old lady that told us to collect all four.
Crazy old ladies are the infomercials of the past.
Did she tell us there has to be a better way? Because that's...
I don't think the infomercials for, like, gold bullion and collector's plates really say that there's a better way for anything, because they're advertising plates.
Look,
that you shouldn't
you
eat
buy
off of.
These coins, they're a dollar
they're better,
a coin.
Yeah, they're a solid investment, and...
You get 20 of them, and they're made of gold, so you can sell them for, like, $6 million a piece.
The price of gold continues to rise. Put these in a treasure chest to entertain your children.
Well, and then we get a non-gold ring.
These coin collectors don't know how to entertain children, let me tell you. What is this?
Yeah,
it's
you
coin.
Should lock them away for your kids to never play with, because this is literal pirate gold.
Speaking of treasure chests...
They continue to not have gold.
Yeah, well, at least they got maggots.
Yeah, you just boil some maggots and stuff in a pot, and then...
I'm sorry, little Billy, you can't play with my pirate gold. But here are some maggots.
You remind me of my uncle, Ladderface.
Which one?
The one that kept maggots.
Ah, yeah. Old... Uncle
old
Freddy
Maggots.
Jim. Yeah. He just was really hung up on maggots after he left the army.
Is that an entire mansion? Did you match
that
up?
Mansions the mansions themselves.
I mean, at best, that was a two-bedroom.
No, it could have been a McMansion.
There was another one. Indeed, there's another one in the background. If you look.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's behind all those trees.
If it's a McMansion, it's one of those awful ones that's like two bedroom, four bathroom. who needs that many bathrooms?
Me?
I need to be able to poop in two bathrooms at the same time.
Yeah. No, I like to do a rotation, you know? I never want to poop in the same bathroom more than once in a row.
However, this here, there's something different about this grave. So clearly, we have to pay our respects to the fallen rose.
Did we kiss it? Did the rose kiss us? That rose on the grave?
Kiss us, and we teleported to a secret place.
It's pretty gray here where we got kissed by the rose.
Uh-huh. Grave. Spelled G-R-E-Y-V-E. For euros.
We're gonna have meet the new friend.
Is that meat with M-E-A-T?
No, we already got Meat Boy.
Hey, it's that guy from... Is that from the Vampire Dishwasher?
Yes, it is from that game.
Which
and,
is what I assume they are borrowing the aesthetic from.
And I think the character's name is Yuki, if I remember correctly.
I'm pretty sure it's Vampire Dishwasher.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
They wouldn't put it in the title if it wasn't the character's name.
Yeah.
We are playing Dust in Elysian Tale, and the main character is Dust, so obviously this checks out.
When you play Sonic the Hedgehog, you're Mario, so...
Yeah. Well, yeah.
My dishwasher doesn't work.
I need to find a vampire dishwasher. Oh no.
Somebody needs to give the dishwasher some blood.
I played a bit of that Dishwasher Samurai Vampire Undead video game. It's fun enough.
Yeah, it's a pretty nice feeling beat 'em up with an art style.
Good work. Nailed it.
Nailed it. It had the Vampire Dishwasher.
Oh, I get it.
Uh-oh.
You made a pun.
Did I?
Did I?
Did I make a pun now?
I'm so confused.
You said nailed it. We're talking about a vampire game? And I thought that...
Like if he had said staked it, that'd be one thing. If we were talking about Jesus, then you could say nailed it.
Dang. I guess stakes really are just wooden nails, though, aren't they? So...
But, let me say the word nail... And you're either thinking about, like, a metal thing, or a penis.
I'm thinking of the Namekin that fused with Piccolo to
Same.
Super Piccolo.
Yep.
So, fuck you.
I believe they called
When you're
him
saying
pale?
Fuck you, you're either thinking of... Never mind.
Anyway, we're doing this trial here, and it's... It's the easiest one, but it's also the least forgiving one.
I see it's got a lot of spikes.
Yeah, you don't do anything except just go with the flow and hit stuff, but...
Yeah, hit things, but don't hit the spikes. The thing you don't want to hit is spikes.
Yeah. And if you're not fast enough, because as you'll see right here, I'll only barely... make the 9,000 mark.
78 points is lots of points.
Yeah. You did it with plenty of points to spare, and that line is still sad as hell.
because you only get to keep all the shitty items.
Oh, you gave me a poopy ring. You can have it, I guess. Next time you come here, could you bring me some Subway?
You know he's a shitty line when he's asking for Subway. It's like the last meal.
Yeah, well, I mean...
Swing for the fences, dude. You're stuck here forever.
He's so sad that even Subway would cheer him up.
I don't even care what kind of bread it is. Just like any Subway.
Just
salad,
just
that's
wild.
Fine. Sure.
No wrong answers here, mister.
Anyway, right here near, you'll see that the map kind of ends, which means there's an entrance to a mansion here. already. And there's a troll here. Kind of escaped from the wrong area, but no matter.
You'll get him. You got him. Yeah, you got him like 7 seconds ago. And you don't need positive reinforcement. You probably actually got him like 7 days ago.
If not longer.
70 years ago, Jeff got the drolk. Trolk.
But the trolk died this day, 70 years ago.
Could have been my trolk in that car. She's been dead for 70 years.
If a trolk dies and no one sees it, is it really dead?
Probably.
Yeah. If I die and nobody sees it, I'm probably boned. So, yes.
Unlike a troll, you would live on in our hearts, Jim.
Yeah. Oh, so nice. That's really nice of you.
Also, Jeff, I can't help but feel that you're being very wasteful leaving those wall chickens behind on the previous screen.
I know, I know.
He's got 33 wall chickens. It's fine. He's got 36 wall chickens.
I could always use more, to be honest.
But when he has them in his inventory, they keep forever. But if he just leaves them there on the floor, they just disappear.
Ghosts can eat them.
Yeah.
Maybe she's really hungry.
He's a fucking ghost. He can't eat chickens.
How do you know he can't eat chickens?
I'm gonna cite Ghostbusters here that he
can.
Do
ghosts hate KFC?
No.
Because Slimer ate a lot of junk. The hot dogs fell through, but I think the soup stuck in there.
I'm going to have a separate account from Harry Potter here in saying that while ghosts cannot consume food, they can still sense, particularly like stimulating foods, like rotten foods.
I ain't just playing with your wall chicken.
So if we leave the wall chicken to the ghost, he's just gonna let it sit and rot on the floor so he can, like, feel something.
Hey!
It's gonna be like a fucking Cure song, okay?
Hey, Ladface!
What?
Eventually, that wall chicken's ghost will show up, and then he can eat the wall chicken's ghost.
That is a horrible fate!
No! He gets to eat the wall chicken, he just has to wait for it to become a ghost like him!
This ghost is, like, made out of poison and or bile or puke. I don't think he deserves anything.
Now I see what it is. This is just a straight-up case of ghost racism.
Yeah, man. Why you gotta be such a... Aww.
He is the ghost of a McMansion. Who cares?
Look, maybe he just wants to emulate having flesh, and he just rubs the chicken on his body all day.
If he wants to emulate having flesh, he shouldn't just chase around some cat person all day.
Fair enough.
We're the only ones here. The only zombies here. You don't want zombies. Zombies are gross.
You call me a ghost racist, and then you're
actually,
like, oh, fucking zombies are gross. I know. You're both against me. So you are now one person. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. That's fair. They call me
a cable TV pundit. I will, combine everyone against me into a single entity.
Ah, the good old Sean Hannity strategy.
Yes?
If the argument really starts going bad, I'll start calling them terrorists.
Well, you are arguing in favor of zombies. Or against them, or something. I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention.
Something is being argued here.
You see, you used the word zombies, so maybe you're actually the real racist.
We can't use the word zombies when you're describing zombies, otherwise it's weird and meta. So you have to say walkers, or the undead, or whatever.
The preferred term is undead Americans.
I call him Jeffrey.
Jeff? just because you met one dude who was dead and called Jeffrey?
Yeah, no, that's what they like to be called. Jeffrey told me so.
This is getting into weird places that we shouldn't be.
What's your problem with Jeffrey?
To the cafe.
Did you know Jeffrey that hurt you?
No, I haven't known. The only Jeffreys I've known have been alive and white, so I can't comment here.
Okay. What's in this chest, Jeffrey?
Hot dogs?
Oh, delicious.
There's hot dogs in this chest.
How long have they been there?
Not long enough to become ghosts, clearly.
Otherwise, it would say ghost hot dogs.
So. Like, you know, it was inside a box, but it was a box that was colored red, so I would not assume it was an ice box.
I'm sure just hot dogs in a box are good to eat. I mean, come on. Hot dogs.
I'm gonna mail you a box of hot dogs, Jim. And you can tell me if they're good to eat or not.
Do I have to eat them to find out?
Yeah, well, you can decide.
Okay.
You don't have to eat them to prove a point. But if you want to prove your point, you would have to eat them.
Okay, I see. I'll keep this in mind when the hot dogs arrive.
I'm counting on it.
What if I just mail you sausages?
I don't think those are hot dogs.
Only dogs can tell the difference. Or can't tell the difference. I don't know.
I think sausages look like combos. If I remember my dog treat lore correctly. As the owner of a dog,
yo,
it's
dude,
totally
are these,
okay.
Are these those pepperoni combos? Nah, dog, those are sausages. Oh, cool. Cool. Probably cheaper. I don't know.
Nah, dog.
I'm not your dog, dog.
Hey, we're in the very last mansion.
Oh, the final mansion.
The final mansion.
Is this mansion also full of hot dogs?
And the last item we need to collect is Luigi's rotting corpse.
Nice.
That was in the DS one.
For the end of Luigi's Mansion 2.
Yeah. Or 3DS.
Well, he is green, so, you know, it's possible.
It was Luigi all along.
Oh, did you see the sick dodges?
I did.
I didn't need to get that key, but I did.
Nice. Good work, just a friend.
You also
You're really
didn't need to
showing
get...
this mansion who's boss.
Didn't need to get that other key that you skipped like a minute ago, apparently.
Well, the other key was inaccessible at the time being.
What?
I didn't have
you
the
could,
right
You could totally spin... Spin cancel
no,
up there.
You kind of can't because it's not a completely vertical wall.
No, okay. I'll believe you, but I'll continue to be suspicious.
Look, I could bullshit you with mechanics that you might not know exist, but they do exist.
Mechanics are real and they exist. That's all of
them. I'm sensing a pattern. Yeah, I'm sure, like, you couldn't possibly use your little bat helper to do a thing.
Well, you know, she could have picked up every single item by just flying 2 inches higher, but...
Nah. Things with wings never help you. It's like that owl in Legend of Zelda. I've got wings, Link, but you know what? Get fucked.
He does help you once.
No,
to get down the mountain.
No, he just tells you things and calls you an idiot and...
And then puts a cursor on yes when he asks you to tell, ask you if you want to hear it again.
He asks it in a really weird way, too. He's like, you don't want to hear that again, do you? He's like, wait.
You want that I should maybe tell you that again or not?
No, yeah. Sure.
I'm an owl. I work in mysterious ways. These were my husband's. I could talk all day. I could also taco day. Love tacos.
I love tacos too. Is there any wall tacos?
There are a lot of food items, but tacos, I think there are none.
You know, if we ever hung out, I could definitely turn some wall chickens into some wall tacos.
Whoa, that's miraculous.
Transubstantiation from meat to taco form is not that difficult as a food alchemist.
What did he do? I suppose you only really need a knife. So you can cut the meat into strips.
If it's cool enough, you can just, you know, shred it with your fingers.
Yeah, I guess that's true too.
Assuming you have fingers.
Well, ghosts don't. Let me
guess. Well, ghosts don't. Was Gaius. Are we really gonna get into this argument again about ghosts and food?
Just a pattern I've been noticing is all.
Good. Good. Because I think ghosts would like order the wrong type of tacos anyway. And now he is trapped
in this place, consuming. What is the wrong type of taco? I'm intrigued.
A non-ethereal taco?
Can I get like a vegetarian taco without a tortilla?
So what, just a pile of lettuce?
I don't know, man. I'm not a ghost.
You're right, that is the wrong taco. It's just lettuce.
That might have some salsa, maybe beans, if you're lucky.
I guess you could use a kale leaf for a tortilla instead.
It's just like a piece of seaweed with taco seasoning in it. And then salsa.
Wouldn't call it a taco, but I'm not thinking it would be that bad either.
You could do a lot worse. The connection should break.
Then I can cast the demon back. How about we just ask the ghost herself while we fight him?
Okay. They won't, man.
I've tried a lot of times.
Is it time to beat up a ghost and find out his secret vegetarian taco secrets?
Yes.
Gluten-free. Well, I guess you could have corn if you're gluten. No gluten. You could have corn tortillas.
We're gonna eat food.
Yeah!
Upper defense and attack.
Eat some chipong!
Because...
I mean...
Kane
like
is not a difficult boss, but he's probably the hardest. Just because he has a lot of HP, and his attacks are really hard to avoid. And you can't... You can parry them, but... When you parry them, you just get knocked back to the other side of the screen.
The best way to sham a ghost is to challenge them to an eating contest.
Because they're bad at it.
Yeah, just falls right on through. Like, this guy has some bones and stuff, which he has over a lot of ghosts, but, like, stick-to-your-ribs meals are not literal.
I think this guy could eat oatmeal. That'd probably stick far enough.
If he like, poured the whole bowl in it once, maybe. But if you took it bite by bite, I'm not sure.
Well, now he's double dead. The worst kind of dead.
Maybe he should
He's alive again. Now he turned into an actual ghost.
Now he's a Jedi ghost thing.
You destroyed his ghost form, and now he's a ghost.
We destroyed the evil skeleton form, and now he's a real ghost. A ghost sans bonus. Terrible things. I betrayed my
friends. Turned them over to General Gaius for money.
He fucked all of us over.
My life.
This mansion. Everything I
ever owned was bought with the blood. He was a racist. It's okay, my love. I know everything. That is why I left you. But I have come to help you set things right once again. Oh, shit. She was the wife of a war crimesman. I should have trusted
you. I should have told you. She doesn't have to testify against him. I know this. This is a real law. Wait, let me check my iPhone app.
She really seems like she would have appreciated a a paid trip to The Hague.
And you, Rogue One, you helped drive that demonic presence away. I owe you a debt of thanks.
That's how you pronounce it, right, Jeff? Be truly
repaid. Pronounce what? You can
repay the Hague? Now.
You worked with I believe you pronounce it Cluedo.
Also, home of the International War Tribunal or whatever.
Jeff is.
Well, technically, it's Den
Haag. Haag.
But that's probably too hard to pronounce, so don't even bother.
Oh, Americans, just like say whatever you want. We don't give a fuck.
Call
we know you're gonna be wrong.
If you want.
There was a village of Moonblood sympathizers in the mountains.
Call it you too, we don't care.
Look, I can't pronounce TH, so...
You seem to do okay there.
Actually, you totally can. You did it right now, Jeff. I heard it. I heard it on the internet.
Well, I can spell it. I can't pronounce it.
The sound. I think you can go... Or th...
That's what I did. The work of the demon
that imprisoned me, no doubt. With your I mean, you do it all the time when you say the word "the." To leave this
valley before it could but sometimes I say twin souls. "the."
The but, like people do that the, all across that, our that, country, that. All the time.
Yeah,
people
I'm
in Chicago
proof.
Say "da" all the time when they get mad. Especially.
I'm talking about these guys over here and these. This guy. And that dude!
I mean, sometimes people in Chicago pluralize people as yous. A yous. But especially when they're mad.
I was in Chicago for like an hour once. It's true.
Yeah. Well, you probably stood on some old guy's lawn and were a
nah,
kid. Hey, yous,
nah.
Kids!
I was waiting for a bus into Wisconsin.
Oh.
Because that's what you do. That's what you do in Chicago, apparently.
You wait for buses to Wisconsin.
Yeah.
You tell them that your name is Jan Janssen and you come from Wisconsin and you work in the lumberyard there.
Yeah.
These are all true facts about the Midwest of United States of America's.
Oh goodness, it's a rain call happening.
You've got the sleeps.
Cut that
the
part
rain
out.
Call itis.
I was only in Wisconsin for about a year. I don't know what they do there. They don't say use, though.
If they pass out during RoboCop.
Yeah. Hey, you beat a boss?
Yes! We did chapter 3. Wow.
You solved all the mansion problems.
I didn't see what your percentages are
did
at.
That, Luigi.